Hi guys, and welcome to today's consultation. Thank you for joining, thank you for subscribing, thank you for sharing. And last week we had a very interesting discussion with our own Robert, a clinical nutritionist, and now today we are going to focus on the management of COVID in the matters of nutrition. Thank you and welcome. Karibu sana Robert again. It was fun having you last week, and we promised we are going to address COVID because we've had kunywa maji ya ndimu, drink a lot of ginger, take a lot of lemon. Lemon is now 50 shillings. Kindly, let us manage COVID nutritionally.
Okay, thank you, Emmy. So, COVID, I would say it's a respiratory condition that is transmitted by a new virus called corona. And it causes illness to humans. It might cause mild, moderate or severe illness to human. So nutrition becomes a very important when it comes to management of COVID. This is because immunity is very important when it comes to fighting any disease, because we have germs in the environment. They could be bacteria, viruses, parasites. All these needs to be checked by your immune system. Once you have a strong immune system, it means that you'll be able to take care of this. I'm saying this because, as we have seen in the media, immunity has been shown to play a major role when it comes to COVID. We are seeing in various countries like Italy, where we had a lot of people dying. And majorly, those who are dying are the elderly. This is because once you get old, our immune system tend to become weaker. And that means that we are not able to fight these infections. So immunity plays a great role when it comes to management. Then again, the other thing that may affect immunity with age is the conditions, because you find that the more we get older, the more we tend to have some of the non-communicable diseases. For example, diabetes, hypertension, cancer, all those that comes with age. And that's the reason the elderly are being affected by this condition more than the young ones. So when it comes to management, we have various food groups that we need to include. So we have what we call green and green products. We have legumes, we'll go to details. Then we have fresh, that would be meat and meat products. We have eggs, we have milk, we have nuts, fruits and vegetables. All these are important when it comes to management. One of the symptoms of COVID is high temperatures. And you find that when you have high temperature, your body needs a lot of energy. So, in fact, we say that it's a hypercatabolic condition.
That's true.
That raises the body temperature.
What he's saying when he says hypercatabolic, it means metabolism is really high.
True.
So if you are not taking carbohydrates enough, it makes you weak.
And here, when it comes to energy, increasing energy in hypercatabolic condition, we say total energy, because almost all food that we take give us energy. So we need to increase the amount of energy when we have high temperatures. But you find that most of the time when we have the high temperatures, the feeding is not good.
But there's no appetite.
There's no appetite. So what you need to do if you're in a hospital, it depends where you are. If you're in a hospital setup and you're not feeding well, that's where we may include supplements. We have various supplements which are high energy, which can be given to supplement the little you are taking through mouth. And if you're not able to take through mouth, then we can also supplement through taking foods through the veins.
We give you
food through the vein to make sure that you are having enough energy. So this need a lot of calculation. So nutrition is working in hospitals are in a position to calculate the amount of energy that is required to do that. But we have some particular foods which are good for immunity. So we have vitamins. So and of interest would be vitamin C. Then we have vitamin D. Then we have zinc. Yeah. So these ones are very important when it comes to our immunity. So vitamin C is mostly found in citrus fruits. This could be oranges.
Mangoes.
They could be, limes. They could be the lemons.
The ones that are now
the ones that
stock.
People are taking a lot. But that does not mean that if we don't have lemon, then we don't have enough vitamin C.
And it does not mean that you take a whole lot of lemons.
No.
The body will take a small quantity.
Yeah, the body will take a small quantity. So there are various foods that you can eat to have vitamin C. So like nowadays it's very hard to find lemon in the market, and when you find them they are very expensive. So I would advise go for other cheaper options. Go for other because there are so many fruits in the market which will give you the
as long as it has citrus.
As long as it has citrus, it will sort you up. So vitamin C is very important when it comes to immunity. Then the other one is vitamin D. Vitamin D is basically sunlight. But you find that most of us, including you who work in offices, have a deficiency of vitamin D.
It's true.
If I ask you, when is the last time you went out purposely to bask?
If I ask you.
Yeah.
I think it's something we rarely do. And because of the nature of our work, we find ourselves in the offices the whole day. And now, that's why people are told when you have COVID, please go to the sunlight. You can't supplement vitamin D anywhere.
You need sunlight.
Sunlight.
You need to bask, and when you are actually dressed, because you need the skin to be in contact with the sun. So vitamin D is very important. But for vitamin D, I'm tempted to give supplements because most of us don't get enough levels, and then it depends on the time at which you are going to bask. Sometimes the sun is too hot.
Wow.
Yeah, it's not recommended to go to the sun when it's too hot.
So we can say, if you are not able to bask when as it is supposed to be, it's okay to see a nutrition to give supplements.
That one is okay. Then the other one would be zinc. Zinc is found in various foods that we take, and one of them would be legumes. And I say legumes, I mean beans and the family. It could be
dengu, kamande.
The
njugu iko hapo?
Njugu iko hapo pia.
Nuts zote.
So zinc is very important when it comes to strengthening our immunity. What I would say, when you are trying to get zinc from legumes, they need to be soaked. The more you soak them, the more you increase their bioavailability. By bioavailability, I mean you make the zinc more available for your body to absorb. So for example, you plan to take beans, just soak them like overnight, then the next day just boil them. That will increase their absorption.
So when you just boil them, it does not it's not the same as when you soak them.
Once you soak, you tend to remove some substances that could bind the zinc from being absorbed. We call them phytates.
Is it those things that when you don't soak beans, they give you gas?
They are the same. They're the
same. So please soak beans, soak cereals, like all cereals needs to be soaked.
The ones like for the beans family, the black beans, the njahe, the beans, they need to be soaked before cooking.
So those things that give gas are not good things. What is the name?
They are called phytates.
Phytates?
Yes.
Wow. Okay. I'm sure I know how to write it. Phytates.
Phytates. So it depends with your pronunciation.
Your English teacher. All right.
Yeah.
Zinc. We've started with vitamin C.
Vitamin C.
Vitamin D.
D. Then
and zinc.
Yeah. Yeah.
You don't need to have zinc supplements. Really, when you have cereals?
Not really. You don't need to have. Not unless you are in hospital and...
True.
Yeah, and we really feel like you are not feeding well, your intake could not be adequate. At that time, you can supplement.
But if you are healthy, you are home, you are good, mm-hmm. you are okay, please do a lot of legumes.
Mm-hmm.
Not a lot, but amount, yeah. a proper amount. I'm with the nutritionist here.
Yeah.
And then let's do sun basking.
Yeah.
If you are not having enough sunlight, you can see them, they give you supplements.
Yeah.
Then let's do vitamin C.
Yeah.
The citrus family.
Yeah.
If lime is not available, look for machungwa, maembe, and all those class of fruits.
Yeah.
Citrus is inakuanga tukali kidogo, like all
they are
fruits.
They are salt. Once you take, you feel the
soreness. All those are in the same family.
They are the same family.
Okay.
Yeah. Then we have fruits and vegetables. Eh? So for fruits, we need to focus on ones which are high in vitamin A, because by the color of fruit you can tell the vitamins. Eh? For example, the yellow colored fruits are high in vitamin A. Yeah, the maembes are high in vitamin A.
That's what you say, but on ndizi. I don't think
ndizi is not really, but
ndizi is not
potassium,
a fruit.
Yeah, but we have the oranges. The colored fruits, the yellow colored fruits, they have got some vitamin A, which is very important. So we have the maembe, the papayas, popos, they are good sources of vitamin. And when it comes to the respiratory conditions, a deficiency in vitamin A can make it worse.
Repeat that, please.
Yeah.
Repeat that, please, for the people, for the sake of COVID.
Yeah. So vitamin A is very important when it comes to management of respiratory conditions, which where COVID is a respiratory condition. Mm. So having not adequate levels of vitamin A can make it worse. So we should make sure we have enough vitamin A levels. And we are saying that the yellow colored fruits are important, and currently or now maembes are on season, so we encourage you to take fruits which are on season, one because they are cheap and they are easily available,
and highlight to them that they don't have to come for supplements when there is a lot of maembe, unless you are sick.
No.
Because everybody is rushing to health sector asking for vitamin A supplement.
No, there's no need.
And vitamin A supplement has effects.
In fact, vitamin A, it's a category of what we call fat-soluble vitamins, which means that there's a high chance of toxicity.
Yes.
You can take, and it will harm you. Yeah, it will harm you.
Effect.
It's not like vitamin C, whereby it can be removed via urine, via sweat.
Mm-hmm.
But not for vitamin A, it's stored in the liver. So you can damage your liver.
Liver toxicity.
You can have what you call hypervitaminosis.
Exactly.
Yeah, so you should focus on
so
diet.
So please kindly, people, stop coming to the health facility and asking for vitamin A supplements, because, yes, you are protecting yourself from COVID, respiratory issues, but you are affecting your liver. You will end up with us with the liver toxicity, and we'll start managing. Liver does not have a transplant in this country. You spoil it, you've spoiled it, isn't
it? True.
Yes. Another class of...
Then you have fruits and vegetables, but we are focused on fruits. But apart from the dark, for the yellow colored fruits, we can also have the other fruits, because we are saying there's no fruit that is more superior than the other.
Mm-hmm.
So you just need to take a variety. If you take an orange, tomorrow you can take a pawpaw, the other day you can take a banana.
Mm-hmm.
So you just need to take a variety, because you might find one vitamin in this fruit and but lacking the other fruit. For vegetables, we also have the dark green vegetables and also the yellow colored vegetables. So all vegetables which are yellow colored have vitamin A. For example,
we have vegetables with yellow color.
Yeah.
Cabbage.
Like pumpkin.
Pumpkin is a vegetable.
Yeah, pumpkin is a vegetable. Yeah, it's a vegetable. So so like pumpkin, it's yellow in color, so it's quite high in vitamin A, and it can be included in the diet. Huh?
Mm-hmm.
We also have the dark-green leaf vegetables, which are also
locally available in all markets.
Yeah, and they are good in vitamin A, vitamin. They have also some good level of vitamin C,
mm-hmm.
so they can be included in our diet.
Mm-hmm.
The terele, the managu, the
saga,
kunde, the saga,
the mito.
Oh, yes.
All those vegetables.
All those vegetables need to be included in the diet. Huh? They apart from vitamins, they also got some minerals which are very important. Huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so let us focus on taking a lot of fruits and vegetables.
Mm-hmm.
And also, for vitamin C, I would say its requirement also will differ depending on the health condition of an individual.
Mm-hmm.
For example, those who smoke a lot, and their requirements of vitamin C is very high.
Also?
Yeah, so for those chain smokers, so for those vitamin C supplements can be prescribed to them because they require a lot of vitamin C because of the smoking.
The smoking, yes.
Their
lungs are already compromised.
Sure.
What of the asthmatic patients?
Also the asthmatic.
They need a lot of vitamin A.
They need a lot of vitamin A, vitamin C,
Mm-hmm.
And also a bit of exercise.
Exercise helps.
Exercise help in making sure that your immunity is kept on check.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes.
So when you are managing COVID,
mm-hmm.
diet way,
mm-hmm.
Meat and meat products don't really play a major role, but they are supposed to be taken anyway.
I will not say they don't play a role.
A major. I meant a major.
Okay. Not really a major, but it should be included in the diet
mm-hmm.
because there are some minerals or some vitamins which are in meat that cannot be obtained in vegetables.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
For example, vitamin B12.
Oh, yeah.
It cannot be found in
anywhere else except in meat.
Yes. So meat you need products. To take meat products. Also, zinc. Meat has got high levels of zinc as compared to
vegetables and fruits.
And yes, so it should be included in the diet, but what needed is moderation. Take anything in moderation. Don't say that I never take meat to give me disease. No. You should take all foods in moderation.
What about ginger? Because it has also been overused and turmeric.
So those ones are good to be included in our diet. They are in class of foods called nutraceuticals. So they have got some healing power in them. For
mm-hmm.
example, ginger has got an element called gingerol,
mm-hmm.
so which is very important when it comes to strengthening our immunity.
Mm.
So the ginger, the garlic, the turmeric, all this should be included in our diet. Apart from adding taste, we have got other roles that they play in strengthening our immunity. So I would advise when cooking, let's make sure we utilize
the ginger,
the garlic.
Whether cooked or raw, does it have change of nutrients?
Not really. And if it's this an affection, it's just minimal. It's minimal. It's not like vitamin C that when you overheat,
mm-hmm.
it just destroy it. No.
So let's do a summary
mm-hmm.
of the nutrients you need to have,
mm-hmm.
putting emphasis like intentional, and that
yes.
does not mean like you stop doing a balanced diet
mm-hmm.
of the normal way.
Yes.
We should have plenty of vitamin C.
Yes.
Vitamin C is majorly in citrus fruits,
mm-hmm.
citric thing, passion, orange, pineapple.
Yes, pineapple.
And
there.
All those citrus kind of meals.
True.
Vitamin D,
very
which
good.
Is sunlight basking,
mm-hmm.
or if you're not able to, they can do supplements.
Yeah. And
then
also,
let's
mm-hmm.
do,
mm-hmm.
and also what?
And also vitamin D is also found in oils.
Cooking oils.
Yeah, cooking oil has vitamin D. We have some the oily fish. The oily fish has vitamin D, and also to some extent eggs, the yolk has vitamin D.
So the assumption that people are taking cod liver oil, sorry for mentioning that brand in this discussion, it can kind of serve as a purpose somehow.
Yeah, because cod liver oil has also been supplemented with vitamin D. Yeah,
that's true.
So
then we come to vitamin it's, we said C, D, then zinc, then fruits and vegetables.
Yes.
Then, but that vitamin you can also A. do this garlic and ginger and everything in everything. And vitamin A is needed majorly to boost respiratory issues.
Yeah, but it has got so many roles in our bodies. But in regards to COVID, it's very important for the respiratory conditions.
Okay, and vitamin A food is all yellow things, but not banana. Yeah, remember, banana is not a fruit in this class, but it has a minimal vitamin A, isn't it?
It has a minimal vitamin A.
It has a minimal, but majorly potassium.
It has majorly potassium.
Okay.
But we have also some foods which are high in vitamin A. For example, milk. Yeah.
Yeah.
Sometimes when you boil milk, you see that the cream tends to turn to yellow.
Yeah,
it means you have quite a huge amount of vitamin
But that is milk from the cow. If you get from processed milk, you won't have it as much.
The good companies which follow the regulations should have.
Okay.
Yeah, because once they, even if it's removed, they should try and bring it back in fortification.
Okay.
Yes.
So the narrative that you do a lot of ginger, a lot of lemon and everything might be true, but in moderation. Let's take it in moderation. Anything else, parting shot? If today you are put in a panel of health policies in that Afia house and you are told to talk some, to help make a policy nutrition in this country, what will it be? Something pressing that you wish will be in that office?
I wish I was in the panel. Because I would ensure that we heavily invest in the health sector. Because once we have a healthy nation, our economy will grow.
And what are we investing? Like HR, equipment, what will we invest in? Finance or education, or what is it that we're investing in?
Yeah, all aspects, being finance, the education, but I would like now I would focus on finance and make sure that health workers, they have good remunerations and also have good equipment so that they can work well without too much hassles. Then the other thing, I would make sure I re-emphasize on the primary health care. Yeah? Because once you focus on primary health care, that means we limit the number of people getting sick and going to the hospital.
So if it's a line of nutrition alone, what will you encourage the ministry to do?
I will encourage the education sector to adopt classes in nutrition as early as primary schools, so that people are enlightened at their young age, so that at the end of the day they learn about their nutrition, what to eat, and this will make sure that some of the conditions that can be prevented through diet are eliminated. Then the other thing, through the social media and the radio stations, we make sure that
nutrition,
a lot of nutritionists, maybe employed or not employed, have programs in vernacular or in a variety of languages so that people can be enlightened on what to eat. That will play a major role in helping the government.
What's your parting shot?
My parting shot is that nutrition is very important to our lives. And we all need to eat healthy. Like what the father of medicine said, let thy food be thy medicine, and thy medicine be thy food. So let your food be your medicine, and your medicine be food. And if you don't practice that, you find that you'll be eating medicine to keep you alive, rather than eating food to keep you alive.
Wow.
Yes.
That's big. That's huge. That's it from Health Focus desk today, and we've been having Robert, who is a nutritionist in a certain facility in Nairobi. If you want to talk more about nutrition, if you want to get in touch with him, kindly I leave comments. I leave something in the description box, and you'll get to know more about him and consult him and do everything health-wise, nutritionally. Thank you for joining us. Kindly subscribe, kindly like, kindly share. Let's do this again next week. Thank you and bless you.